Hey everybody, it's Nintendo Kid 100. Today I'll be reviewing the Digivice D Power D Arc, whatever you want to call it. Japanese one D Arc, this is the D Power from Season 3 of Digimon Tamers. As you can see, this is the green one. It is version 1 of it. It's Henry's Digivice. I really like this Digivice. It's the one I've enjoyed most because it has a lot of gameplay on it. It's not always exactly the same. You can go through a lot of levels and there's loads of difference from the old ones. Anyway, this will be my first Digivice reviews. If you have the first original Digivice, I'll buy it off of you. Just tell me. Anyway, on to review. As for show accuracy, it's pretty good. It's basically exactly the same except for this, which connects to the other Digivices. And at the top, because it's Japanese, on the show they have a cord thing. This is just to attach to your belt so it'll move. The aim of the game is to take your Digimon and go through the digital world, fight all the devas and battle your way through until you get to the end with everyone's defeated. You can select from a couple of Digimon. You either have Terriamon, Geomon, Renamon, and as you progress through the game you get Lotmon and Impmon. Anyway, the main menu, basically when you start up you'll have your Digimon there, and the way you progress through the game is by taking steps. Your steps are counted in here. I've done 1,000, a really long number. D energy, which helps you digivolve when you're in a battle. Your win ratio against other people, and the P stands for you completed the game. And distance is how far you are until until the boss battle. At the end of each boss battle, you'll be able to move on to another place. Sometimes if you're not strong enough, you'll have to switch place and find Calamon, who will give you a Digivolution card. Anyway, on the main menu, you can either have status, which you pick your Digimon. Also, it tells you their stats, which is, if you really want to make it go quicker, you do this. It just makes it do quicker because it actually does more. Also, when you're doing the card swiping, the faster you swipe or the slower you swipe will affect the score. With speed, you want medium. With sniper, you want fast-ish. I think it's power and defense. Power you want medium and defense you want slow. When it beeps like it just did, you wouldn't have heard it, but it'll flash your Digimon. And as you can see, I have a battle with a Digimon. On the battle screen here, go to battle card, devolve card, change or escape, or just fight. I would recommend going to battle card, never go to escape or change or anything, that just wastes your turn. Battle card, you can either pick the battle card and use it, or you can go to devolve card. I'm going to use my highest so I can show you my Gargamon. Of course I'm just using any old card. Each different Digivolution costs more. The highest one is 16. Oh wait, I'm not using Terriamon, am I? If you slash it right, you'll get the right one. I got the wrong one because I didn't slash it at the right time. And I got Wargreymon. Your Digimon will shoot a power and it will go across the screen. When your opponent's attacking, you want to press this button as fast as you can to stop it. Once it's stopped, you can select a battle card. I use power because that's my favourite. Just use that. Then it goes through. The attack has gone to 22 to 31. As you can see, you can't really see it, but my attack has got more powerful. The highest I've ever got is to 60, which is that takes up the whole screen. I've now killed him because my attack has overpowered him. I turn back into Geomon and the enemy is dead and I lose my D power, but it just progresses me. If you escape, you just lose 500 steps. If you change, you're more likely to use fight, you're likely to lose. But anyway, that's about it for the D power. Again, if you have any other digivices, tell me. Next I should be reviewing the detector. Anyway, thanks for watching, bye and subscribe.